Today we are going to start matter. This is your second lecture from third chapter. In previous lecture we have discussed state of matter. Also we have discussed different properties of solid, liquid and gases. Actually there are five states: solid, liquid, gas, plasma and Bose-Einstein. But in your class we will discuss about only three states: solid, liquid and gas. And already we have discussed what is solid, what is gas and what is a liquid. Also we have discussed arrangement of molecules and atom in the case of solid, liquid and gases. Now in this lecture we will talk about effect of heat and temperature. What happen when any substances is heated? Let's see. Effect of heat on solid, on heating generally it expand. So I want to demonstrate to show you how metal and solid expand on heating. Let's see and try to observe what I want to show you. Here you can see that a ring is there and one bob is moving through it. But after heating, you will observe that that bob cannot be passed through that ring. It means there is an expansion of that metals. That's why it will be stuck over the ring and you can see it clearly. Now, now we can conclude from this video expansion. What is the expansion? A process in which an object become bigger in size. Expansion means a process in which a object bigger in size on heating, and you have observed already in this demonstration. So my dear students, you can understand that what is a expansion. Here I want to show that what exactly happen on heating. We know that all molecules are closely packed in the case of solid. So what happen on heating, just see and try to understand.
Hello students, this is a mechanism of expansion. Here we know that all solid particles, any substances, they are made up of atom and molecule. And also we know that all molecules are closely packed. It is very clear from the picture, all molecules are closely packed. One thing we know that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can be transformed from one form to another form. Here suppose on heating we start giving heat to this substance, on heating these molecule acquired energy, and after getting energy they start vibrating and all molecules will collide with each other, and after collision one molecule will move in other direction, one molecule will move in other direction and one molecule will move in another direction. When after collision they will move in random direction, So what happened? Here space is very less. But in the case of this picture, space, you can see that it is increasing. And when space will increase, so we can understand that molecules and substance will expand. So on heating, molecule get heated, and after getting energy, they will collide with each other, and after collision, they will move far apart from each other, and spaces will increase. And when space will increase, means there is a expansion. So that is a hello students. This hello students. This is a mechanism of.
So my dear students, it is a very clear what happened on heating. Molecules get heated and they collide with each other, and they start moving and collide with each other, and after collision they move apart from each other, means space, intermolecular space between them increase. When space will increase, means there is a expansion. It is a clear explanation. Here change of state in the case of liquid, we know that water has three state. What is that? Solid means ice, liquid, and last one is that gases. So water has three states: solid, liquid, and gas. So what happened and what is the term I am using in this picture? Try to understand. First, you can see the cube is there. Ice cube is there. On heating, it start converting, start melting into water. You know that the melting point of water is 0 degrees Celsius and freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius. Actually, why it is happening, you will talk about in next classes. But in the starting, there is an equilibrium. What is the equilibrium? That is a very new word for you. So we will talk about that in later classes. So you can understand that on heating, water, ice start melting and it will change into water. Means that is called melting point. And you can understand, suppose anybody will ask what is a melting point, the temperature at which solid start melting into liquid form, that is called melting point. Further, on heating, liquid start boiling and change into water vapor, that is called evaporation or evaporation. Means heating, first heating, it will change into solid to liquid. Further heating, it will change into liquid to gas. And vice versa, on cooling, vapor will change into liquid, water droplets. So here I want to show you that first change of state and endothermic reaction. What is that? Endothermic reaction, the reaction in which energy is absorbed, takes place when energy is absorbed from surrounding in the form of heat. I want to give you example. Suppose you will add some glucose in water, you can see that many water droplets start depositing outer layer of the glasses. Why? Because water, that glass get cooled, and because of lower temperature, when water vapor which are present in air passing through that cooler surface, it will change into water droplets, and that is called condensation. Means you understand what is the endothermic, the reaction in which energy is absorbed, and other hand, the reaction in which energy is released आई थिंक यू आर हैव सीन, यू हैव सीन वाइट वॉशिंग ऑफ द वॉल. व्हेन यू विल ऐड द लाइम इन वाटर यू कैन सी दैट वाटर इज स्टार्ट बॉइलिंग, मीन्स हीट इज रिलीजिंग आउट फ्रॉम दैट प्लेस एंड दैट इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एक्सोथर्मिक रिएक्शन. सो देर आर टू काइंड ऑफ रिएक्शन. In the first one, energy is absorbed, and second one, energy is released. Like, I want to give you example, fusion, vaporization, sublimation, they need temperature, they need heat. On heating, it will happen. Ice will melt into liquid when? On heating. Liquid will change into vapor on heating. Sublimation is heating. Already we have discussed what is sublimation in previous classes also. So that is called endothermic because they require temperature, they require heat. And whereas freezing, condensation and deposition are exothermic because they release energy. So I think you can better understand that what is the endothermic and what is the exothermic. Here, melting, what is the melting? Fusion or melting, the process by which a solid change into liquid state at a constant temperature by absorption of heat is called fusion and melting point. That is another definition is also the temperature at which solid start melting. That is called melting point, and you can write this equation also. So, it's your wish, which one you want to write the definition, you can write that. So here, you can see that melting, ice start melting and it will convert, it start converting into liquid form. Means that is example of melting, solid will change into liquid. Another second example is that condensation. What is a condensation? When water vapor passing through the cooler region, cooler place, what happen? They will start changing into small, fine water droplets. And that is called condensation. You can see that many water droplets are observed over the layer of glass. Because, why it is happening? Because of condensation. So, you can better understand what is a condensation, what is vaporization. Next one is that freezing point. It is clear, freezing point means the temperature at which liquid freezes into solid form. The freezing point is that temperature of a liquid at which it changes into its state and form liquid to solid at atmospheric pressure. Means normal condition. There is no change in pressure because we have a normal pressure outside our the body. Means in environment, in the normal condition. You can see that freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius. And also I think you have discussed what is a Fahrenheit and what is a Celsius. Sublimation. Sublimation, a process in which solid on heating, it will directly change into gas. There is no any liquid state. Means solid will change into gas and further vice versa on cooling, gas will change into solid. Means solid to gas and further gas to solid. Means in between that there is no any liquid state. That is called sublimation. Sublimation is a process in which solid change directly to a gas without going through the liquid state. There is no any liquid state. So I want to give you some example also. What is a solidification? That is the opposite of sublimation. Suppose solid on heating, it will change into gas. And on cooling, that gas will be changed into solid form, that is called solidification. The process in which a gas directly changes into solid state on cooling is called solidification. Here you can see the example in a picture. Very well explained is there. This picture is also given in your book. So you can see that what is a solidification, what is a sublimation, what is a condensation, what is a evaporation. So I want to make you understand what is a sublimation. Let's see first.
Sublimation.
You have seen the naphthalene ball. It will disappear after some time. Why it is happening? Because of this is sublimine substance. You can see that. You can see that very clear from the video. There are few substances like ammonium chloride, naphthalene ball, iodine ball, camphor. Camphor means kapoor. On heating, they will directly change into gas. And further on cooling, that gas will directly change into solid state. Means there is no any liquid form. That is called sublimation, and these substances are called sublimine substances. So suppose I will ask, give the example of 3 and 4 examples of sublimine substances. Please keep it in your mind. Ammonium chloride, naphthalene ball, iodine ball and camphor. These are the sublimine substances. Here you can see that naphthalene ball is are using in toilet, basin, and ammonium chloride on heating in that setup. Whatever I am here showing, in China dish, one funnel is there, it is kept upside down, and one cotton ball is plugged in the hole of that funnel, and after heating, you can see that ammonium chloride start changing into vapor, and that collected in a cotton bulb because of cooling. And because of that reason, because of sublimation, gas, solid will change into gas, and gas will directly change into the solid. Means there is no any liquid state. So this is example of sublimation. So my dear student, today is the last topic, sublimation. In next classes, 2 and 3 topics has left. We will talk about that in later. Thank you. God bless you.